In this video covering the A2 specification, we will learn about the concept of dynamic efficiency. By the end of this video, you will be able to define the term dynamic efficiency and be able to demonstrate it on a firm's average cost curve. The term static applies to something at a specific moment in time. For example, a firm may or may not currently be productively efficient. The term dynamic applies to something changing over a period of time. For example, a firm may have the ability to innovate and drive down their costs over a period of time. As mentioned before, dynamic efficiency occurs over time and not at a specific moment like productive and allocative efficiency, which are considered static efficiencies. Dynamic efficiency is the result of investment by firms, usually out of supernormal profits, to innovate and drive down costs. We'll see how this looks on the average cost curve next. Dynamic efficiency considers how a firm manages to reduce its short-run and long-run average costs over time, thus shifting its average cost curve downwards. Let's start with the year 2005 and draw a firm's average cost curve as AC2005. If we assume this firm has some market power and is able to earn supernormal profits, it is then able to invest some of that money back into improving processes and business practices, eventually resulting in greater efficiency and lower costs. Firms are able to do this by investing in human capital or by innovation driven by research and development. Competition can also force innovation that will reduce costs in order to maintain profit levels. This brings us to AC2015. Lower average costs are the result of the investment into innovation 10 years later. By now, you should be able to clearly define dynamic efficiency and represent it on a firm's short-run and long-run average cost curve. If you have any questions, leave them below or email me. You can also visit me online at the Enhanced Tuition website. I hope you found this video helpful. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.